The newest version of VSDC includes a new window we've called a template window. In this video, we'll show you what it is and how you can use it. Okay, assuming you've downloaded VSDC 6.8 already, let's see what's new. If you are using the classic workspace configuration, you'll find the template window right next to the Project Explorer and Object Explorer windows. Let's make a click on it. Hit the button in the bottom left corner to start the synchronization with the server. Keep in mind that such major synchronization is only required once when you first launch the new effect library. From there, whenever we release effect updates, you'll be able to download them faster separately. There will be no need to update the entire library each time. The process may take some time, so please be patient. The reason why it's happening is that the library of VSDC effects is now located in the cloud. It's a more convenient way to send effect and transition updates to the editor installed on your PC. As soon as the synchronization is over, the window will get updated. As you may have guessed, this is a modified version of our good old menu housing video, audio, and text effects. However, with the new format, you'll be able to sort effects and add your own presets to the library. Let's make a right mouse click on the object and look at the options available in the context menu. Add a template, add a child template, add folder, add a child folder, move inside, move outside, remove items, expand all child templates, collapse all child templates, show in effect presets, use default properties, use as a transition, use default duration, synchronize templates, about the template. Now that we've checked this out, let's get to work. For starters, add a video file to the scene. Suppose you want to add the fade-in transition to the video. Start typing fade and you'll instantly have the effect you are looking for pop up in the search. To apply the effect to the video, make a double click on it, and then you can drag it from the template window to the scene or timeline, as long as it's an effect. Remember that effects can't exist on the timeline without the file they're applied to. Now let's suppose we have our own idea of what a fade-in transition should look like. Great! Make your changes to the effect. And save it to the library by clicking the plus sign. You can name it the way you want and move it to any folder, including a new one. Next level. Let's suppose you want to save the template together with the video you've been working on. Easy peasy. Select it with a click and proceed with the plus sign. You'll be able to use this template along with the video anywhere, including adding them to the scene. Now imagine you've used a group of effects instead of just one, and you're planning to use it in your future projects. Convert all the objects into a sprite and click the plus sign in the template window. And yes, you'll be able to use this sprite anywhere as well, including adding it to the scene. One more important thing. Remember that before saving your own templates, it's crucial to check free space on your computer, as well as the physical memory, also known as RAM. And that's about it, young Padawans. You now know how to make the most of the template window. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And remember to give this video a thumbs up if you like the update.